It always amazes me how circumstances, people allow that to sometimes dictate their life and how they respond to crisis and situations. They see something and then attach emotions to it and then get involved in it and can't maintain the balance of recognition that our foundation has to always be on Jesus and on the scriptures that he's given us, as well as our personal relationship to him. Otherwise, we'll be tossed to and fro, not only with wind and doctrine, but also with the things that happen in the world and the circumstances that will always make you go to this way or that way. And I think the greatest thing that we could learn is to stop in our day if something major happens and return to our devotionals, our devotional time, and ask God, you know, what he would say again, because he's obviously prepared us for this. And we should be recognizing that in all of our personal lives, whatever the circumstances may be, it is the Lord who has allowed that into our life to both test us, to try us, and to move us in a direction that would turn to him and ask him what to do next. In God calling, riches. Never let yourself think, we cannot afford this or shall never be able to do that. Say, the supply for it is not here yet, but it will come if we should have it. It will surely come. Persevere in saying that and gradually feeling of being plentiful and plentifully supplied and of being surrounded by riches will possess you. That feeling is your faith claiming my supply, and according to your faith it shall be unto you. But it is not the faith expressed in moments of prayer and exaltation I look for, but the faith that lays immediately to rest the doubts of the day as they arise, that attacks and conquers the sense of limitation. Ask and you shall receive. And, you know, it's not really about prosperity so much as it's about likewise recognizing that we have all provided for us by God everything we need according to not just his riches and glory, but according to godliness and according to righteousness and according to health and wealth and prosperity and our needs and anything that we have in this life, because God said he was going to take us through unto the day of salvation, that we would be presented faultless before the Father. So we need to recognize that we're being taken there and that we need to go there and we need to ask him for help when we need. So don't be afraid to ask so that you can receive, or seek so that you can find, or knock so that the door would be open, because God wants you to have what he has designed for you this day. And all he's waiting for is you to communicate with him, and then he can show you the way and he can provide for you what you need today. I know he has for me. He always does. Even in the heat, you know, I have for some reason ability to not react to it, you know, and I don't notice it right now, but then I'm going back inside.